one for freedom and democracy abroad, and one for freedom and democracy denied at home. So I thank the artists for exercising their sense of agency. I'll say that again. I thank the artists for exercising their sense of agency. They're not just talented men, but they are artists with a voice. And so I thank them for their sense of agency in boldly bringing forth heroic narratives of unheralded patria. I thank you for pushing into relief chronicles that have not been recognized, chronicles that have not been understood, chronicles that have not been appreciated, and chronicles that have not been popularized. With your creative boldness, you have moved us forward toward answering many unresolved questions. But I thank you for doing something far more. That is to say, your images of the African-American presence during World War I have caused us to question answers that we thought we knew, that we thought were accurate, that we thought were complete. Yes, there are questions to be answered, but there are also questions to be answered. And I thank the artists for doing that for us. I close by noting that there is a human need to remember those who champion our values, share our worldview, understand our history, carry forth our struggles, inspire our youth, and protect our communities and society. This exhibition should remind each of us that there are narratives in our collective history that we do not know. The very halls of government are most appropriate places to correctively add missing chapters of our culture history. Thank you to the City of Austin, and thank you again to the artists. This exhibition, providing heroic narratives of unheralded patriots, can teach us. This learning opportunity can improve our cultural literacy. This installation of art can heighten our cultural competency quotient. A picture may be worth a thousand words, but several images constitute an engaging essay. But these paintings, through which we bear witness to history, are the beginnings of an encyclopedia of visual images worth far more than thousands of words. Such images constitute the medicine, the cure, the antidote for our cultural and indeed our historical amnesia. Without question, I encourage everyone to come see and experience Black warriors of World War I, the Harlem Hellfighters. We must never forget the 369th Infantry, formerly known as the 15th New York Colored Regiment. They were the torchbearers of liberty. And I thank the torchbearing artists for bringing exposure to their stories. Thank you so very much.